I'm Pastor Salem. I want to welcome you to the Christian Worship Hour. And we're going to have a sermon today that I think you'll enjoy. It's about Joseph of Arimathaea. Now, what do you know about Joseph of Arimathaea? Well, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. He was a secret disciple. And that's not the best thing to do. So I'm wondering if we have any other secret disciples. I wonder if I'm a secret disciple. So call your friends, tell them, we're going to hear about Joseph of Arimathaea and see what happened to this fellow. We're reading from Mark chapter 15, and this is the story of Joseph of Arimathaea. And if you have your Bibles, start with the 42nd verse. And then we have a prayer, and in our prayer we always pray for the persecuted church somewhere. And this time we're going to pray for the persecuted church in Tanzania. So maybe some of them are getting us. They can get us on, I'm sure they can get us on shortwave and maybe on television. But they need to know we're praying for them and we admire them for their stand. God bless them. All right, Mark 15, verse 42, and now when the even was come, now Jesus has just been crucified. And now when the even was come, because it was a preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathaea, an honorable counselor, which also waited for the kingdom of God, came and went in boldly unto Pilate and craved the body of Jesus. And Pilate marveled if he were already dead. And calling upon him the centurion, he asked him whether he had been any while dead. And when he knew it of the centurion, he gave the body to Joseph. And he bought fine linen and took him down and wrapped him in the linen and laid him in a sepulcher which was hewn out of a rock and rolled a stone under the door of the sepulcher. And so, Heavenly Father, our heart just aches when we read this story of the crucifixion and how you suffered for us. You suffered for me, a poor lost sinner out there in the boondocks and now didn't know up from down, and yet you loved me and saved me just as a child, 10 years old. And you prayed and you saved that great, mighty, powerful Saul of Tarsus, who put people to death, Lord, and persecuted the church, and you forgave all his sins. And so we just thank you for going to the cross. And want to thank you for Joseph of Arimathaea, Lord. Thank you that he did come out of the shadows. He didn't say too much about the Christian life. But now he stands true and goes and asks for the body of the Lord and gives it burial. And out of his life, help us to be strengthened in the Christian life. And Lord, we pray for our brothers and sisters in Tanzania today. And I just, Lord, help them to know that we are encouraged by their life, that their living helps us to live our life here, and we don't face anything like they do. And help them to know that they're going to receive the martyr's crown, and that they're a great witness for you around the world. Give them grace and strength. I know you will, Lord. And someday we'll get to meet these dear brothers and sisters. And won't that be something? So bless us now. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.